Login. Click Start. Whoa! Look at that new Start menu. Open Edit Group Policy. Navigate to Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, App Package Deployment. In the Windows 11 25H2 Insider Preview, OS version build 26200.5670, there is a new Remove Default Microsoft Store Packages from the System Group Policy setting that allows users and IT administrators to remove unwanted Microsoft Store apps. Does it work? The policy is defined in the administrative template file AppxPackageManager.admx, which is located in the C:\Windows\Policy Definitions folder. The related language file .adml is located under the systems language directory, which for me is en-us. The version shipping with the 25H2 Insider Preview is twice the size of the current version. The new template explicitly states that the new policies are supported on Windows 11 25H2. When diffed with the current template version, you will find new policy definitions starting around the line 139 and continuing the line 350. The corresponding registry path is HKEY:\Local:\Machine, Software, Policies, Microsoft, Windows, AppX, Remove Default Microsoft Store Packages. The log events in Event Viewer are captured under Application and Service Logs, Microsoft, Windows, AppX Deployment, and AppxDeployment-Server. To make this setting available across your Active Directory domain, copy the updated .admx and .adml files from your 25H2 Insider machine to the Group Policy Central Store. See my video here to set up a central store. In short, create and populate a policy definitions folder under the C:\Windows\SYSVOL\Domain\Policies folder on one of your domain controllers. Normal SYSVOL DFS replication should ensure it is propagated to the other domain controllers. With the domain central store in place, you can create a GPO for the 25H2 computers that removes the unwanted Microsoft Store apps. However, it is unclear how these settings will affect current 23H2 and 24H2 Windows 11 clients. Therefore, to apply the GPO to only 25H2 computers, create a new WMI filter that filters OS build numbers equal to or greater than 26200. Apply the filter to the new GPO. When enabled, 25 apps can be selected for removal. The items denoted with a single asterisk have no GUI. Items denoted with double asterisks have a default handler for a common file type or protocol. Microsoft does not recommend removing those apps, as doing so may result in a degraded user experience. Here, I'm leaving the default selected and adding a few others to be removed. Open an administrative terminal and run gpupdate/force. Run gpresult with the /h option and specify a file name and path. Open the HTML file, click Show All, and look under the Policies section to verify the settings are in place. Click Start. Well, seems like the apps are still there. Reboot. Log in. Click Start. The apps are still there. Create a new user. Reboot. Log in as the new user. Click Start. And the apps are still there. Although the group policy setting does not appear to be working properly yet, you can still manually remove unwanted Microsoft Store apps. And this method works for all versions of Windows 11 and Windows 10. A standard user can use the remove-appxpackage commandlet to remove a Microsoft Store app from their account. Open a normal terminal or PowerShell session. Use the get-appxpackage commandlet to get a list of installed packages. Use the remove-appxpackage commandlet, passing the package full name property to the dash package option to remove. An administrator can use the remove-appxpackage commandlet with the dash all users option to remove a package from all user profiles on a system from a local or remote administrative terminal or PowerShell session. This may be necessary when performing sysprep to prepare a baseline Windows image. To remove a provision app from the Windows image, an administrator can use the remove-appxProvisionedPackage commandlet. This commandlet will not remove store packages from existing user accounts. It only prevents the remove app packages from being installed when new user accounts are created. Use the get-appxProvisionedPackage commandlet to get a list of provision app packages. Use remove-appxProvisionedPackage-online-package-name to remove from the Windows image. The dash online option, when used in this case, means that the operating system is up and running. The option has nothing to do with network connectivity. You can also use existing group policies to limit and control Microsoft Store apps. Under Computer Configuration, Administrative Templates, Windows Components, Store, the Disable All Apps from the Microsoft Store policy prevents users from using any Microsoft Store app package. This will not only prevent the launch of any pre-installed or downloaded Microsoft Store applications, but it also disables the Microsoft Store app. However, this policy only applies to Windows Enterprise or Education. It does not apply to Windows Professional. The Turn Off the Store Application policy does just that. It prevents the Microsoft Store app from launching. However, it does not prevent pre-installed or previously downloaded store applications from running. This policy applies to Windows Enterprise, Education, and Professional. Instead of setting the Turn Off the Store Application policy at the computer level, you can elect to set the policy at the user level under the User Configuration section. It is important to note that these settings are new and may not be fully functional or fleshed out, since this information is based on a Windows 11 25H2 Insider Preview build from the Dev Channel. Features, functionality, and registry keys may, and probably will, change before the final release. Therefore, limit your application and usage to test and evaluation environments only. Do not use in production. I hope you enjoyed this video, found it helpful and informative. If you have feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please share them in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and share this video with others. Thank you for watching. I truly appreciate it.